Good morning and welcome to the 25th Annual Business and Education Partnership Awards. This is our silver anniversary year, so today is a very special event. I am Jonathan Fleece, Chair of the Manatee Chamber Board of Commerce and also Managing Partner of Blaylock Walters Law Firm. First off, I would like for everyone to please stand and join me in our nation's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. I would also like to spend a few moments this morning to pay tribute to a very special community leader, Manatee Chamber of Commerce supporter, servant, architect, and my friend, Rick Foley. As most of you probably know, we lost Rick last week very suddenly, and I would like to acknowledge him in just a few ways. Marcus Tullius Cicero, Roman orator, made a statement, "The life of the dead is placed in the memory of the living." Rick Foley's life had a tremendous impact on all of us here in this room, especially the Manatee County School District, which we are honoring today. One recent example is the new Manatee Technical College building out east on State Road 70. That's a Foley Bryant, Rick Foley project. And many others throughout our great community. Pirate City, McKechnie Field, IMG Projects, and even the Blaylock Walters Law Firm. So in honor of Rick, please join me in a brief moment of silence this morning in honor of Rick Foley, his late wife Connie, his family, his friends, and the legacy that he will leave behind. Godspeed, Rick. We are pleased that you have joined us this morning to recognize the phenomenal involvement that Manatee County businesses, organizations, and individuals have with our local schools. For many, many years, the Chamber has partnered with our school district to promote, recruit, foster, and recognize business partnerships. We are so very proud that we now have more than 350 flourishing partnerships. One of the Chamber's top priorities is education and workforce development. We have numerous programs, committees, and initiatives working to support this initiative. From Project Teach and our newest program, The Big Bank Theory, to business partnerships and monitoring local school and workforce issues, your Chamber of Commerce is committed to our area students and your future workforce. We appreciate the time you have taken this morning to join us in celebrating business and education partnerships. We hope you leave our awards breakfast this morning with a renewed commitment to our students and our schools. Our youth will inherit the lessons, systems, and earth that we leave them. It is therefore our obligation to educate and empower our youth to make this world better than they found it. I would also like to recognize and thank some of our elected officials for attending our awards breakfast this morning. Please hold your applause to the end. Karen Carpenter, School Board of Manatee County, Bob Gauz, School Board of Manatee County, David Miner, School Board of Manatee County, John Colon, School Board of Manatee County, John Chappie, Manatee County Commissioner, and I tried to see everyone here when I arrived, but is anyone missing that would like to stand or should be acknowledged? Okay, good. Thank you so much for your public service. Before turning the program over, I would also like to thank the wonderful chamber staff that helped put this program together every year. Jenna, where are you? Somewhere backstage, and her team and the chamber staff. And as always, this great facility here that we have, Freedom Village, for hosting. At this point, please allow me to introduce Lynn Lineman, our longstanding member of the Chamber's Education and Workforce Partnership Committee, who will introduce our special speakers for this morning's awards. Lynn?
Thank you, Jonathan. Good morning, everyone. Yes, my name is Lynn, and I'm a male. I've had to overcome. But there sits a very successful attorney with the name Fleece. I'm sorry, Steve Perry made me say it. I am Lynn Lineman with C1 Bank. I'm also been for about 10 years with the Workforce Partnership Committee and Manatee Chamber of Commerce. We thank you all for coming today to help us celebrate these business partnerships. And these are special. I just heard Bob Bart say something a little earlier, that if at some point during this morning you don't tear up, we'll get you help. It's incredible what happens out there, and these are some of the things that we ought to be reading in our headlines. Jonathan, thank you for coming today and for starting us off and for your leadership at the Chamber. Although this day is a joyous one, there's somebody else we need to recognize, an individual for their contributions to our schools, and a sad day for all of us who worked very closely with her. The former chair of our Education Workforce Partnership Committee, Chairwoman Ellen Aquilina. Ellen lost her battle with cancer earlier this year, but we believe that her legacy as an advocate for education and a committed supporter of the Business and Education Partnership Program will live on in everyone she touched through her volunteerism in the school and her love for our community's children. We would like to observe a moment of silence also for Ellen and her unwavering dedication. Thank you, and Ellen, thank you for everything that you did. Okay, now, for a little physical exercise, this is as much as we're gonna get in the next hour or so. Please take out your cell phone. Usually on the side, there's a little button. You push it, and it goes to vibrate. If you have any soreness anywhere in your body, place the phone over that sore area, and every time you get a phone call, it'll feel great. Jonathan and I are just so happy that we got through the moments of silence without going off, so please turn those off. We would appreciate it. It'll make the morning much more enjoyable. All right. Now, allow me to thank our chamber. We got a lot of things to do before we even get into the really good stuff, but allow me to thank our chamber platinum members and gold, silver, and bronze members for their support. We wouldn't be here without them. I'd also like to extend a special thank you to MET, Manatee Educational Television, for taking time out of their busy schedule to record this event so the community can see what a tremendous impact our businesses are having on the education of our children. Thank you to my good friend Charlie Clapsaddle. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Hey, Charlie. Give him a hand. And the staff of METV. They do a great job. I've been doing this for 10 years, and he's been here doing that before I was. So thank you, Charles, so much. We sure appreciate you. There are many other people who have helped make this awards breakfast possible, and their names are listed in the program. We thank them all for their support. Please be sure not only to mention your appreciation, but to show your appreciation to them as you do business with them. They are Freedom Village, Lavino Power Systems, Allison Gauze Engineering, Palm Printing, my buddy Don Hyde with the trophy case, and Tropicana Products, and of course, our presenting sponsor today, Bright House Networks Business Solution. Bright House Networks Business Solutions has provided a majority of the financial support necessary for this event today. Their generous contributions and longtime dedication to the education in our community are exemplary of the business support necessary to make these business partnerships a success. Please join me in thanking Bright House Business Solutions for their support. And would Dennis Schaefer please come up and share a few words with us? Dennis is the I love this title. He's the Director of Strategic Partnerships, and that's what we're all about today. So let's give Dennis and Bright House Business Network. Thank
you, sir. Right ahead. Okay, I'm good. Right ahead. Locked in. Good morning. For those of you that don't know where that button is on your phone, I saw 2 5-year-olds running around here. They can probably help you out. Bright House Business Solutions, excited to be part of the presenting sponsor for this year's Manatee's Chamber of Business and Education Awards. We pride ourselves in the educational involvement and are proud to sponsor the Manatee Education Foundation Cash for Classroom Grants, the Bradenton Herald Golden Herald Awards honoring students giving back to the local community, and all third and fourth grade field trips to the South Florida Museum so you can learn about Florida's great history. Bright House Networks also hosts several educational awards programs honoring local students and educators, including the Classroom Innovators Grant and Future Leaders Scholarship Awards, and Bright Ideas, STEM, for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math from today's youth programs. We know that today's youth are tomorrow's leaders. They're also tomorrow's entrepreneurs, innovators, and inventors. They're our best hope for a brighter future. They're the ones who can help create new opportunities for our local economies to prosper and flourish. At Bright House Networks, we live and work where you do. We're investing in our community's classrooms because that's where today's students are preparing for a future in a global marketplace. I want to thank the Manatee Chamber for providing us this opportunity. Thank you all for your attendance and enjoy today's program.
Thank you, Dennis. And as he's walking down, remember this. If you don't have a bright house, you could have a dim house. So let's brighten it up. Brighten it up. I'm sorry. As a longtime host of this special awards program, Freedom Village Continuing Care Retirement Community continually shows their support for our students through hosting events such as this one and through student scholarships. Our good friend Veronica Rogers is on vacation this week, so they sent in the big gun. And Brian Parsons, the administrator. Brian, are you here? Okay. Brian will come up and share some things from Freedom Village, and we sure thank them and him for having and hosting us today. Let's give him a hand.
Well, good morning. It's great to have everybody here at Freedom Village this morning. If I say I'm up here a lot, I get really freaked out by talking in public. I'm a healthcare administrator. I run my 120-bed facility, or the health center across the street, but welcome to Freedom Village, and for taking the time out of your guys' busy day to be here. I can't say enough about the Manatee County school systems, but also the businesses in Manatee County. I worked in this area a number of years ago, left, went over to Pinellas County, and then came back. The reason why I came back is my wife actually works for Manatee County Schools, and she says, you have a choice. Either we move, or I'm retiring. So we moved. But it's great to be here at Freedom Village, and I'm learning a lot, and I thank Veronica for giving me the opportunity to speak to you guys. But business and educational partnerships are really important to the Bradenton community in many ways. With a community like Bradenton, the size of the community, more than ever we need to partner with education and businesses to give our young people an opportunity to grow. Here at Freedom Village, we give our associates the opportunity to grow in regards to the scholarship programs that we have each year that we have our associates participate in. Last year, the total scholarship amount was in excess of $80,000 that was given, which is pretty phenomenal considering that the scholarships mainly come from donations from the residents, and I just found out actually a couple of weeks ago that they actually have a thrift store here that they take donations to, and they actually get money for the scholarship program through the thrift store as well. So I can't thank the residents of Freedom Village enough for taking their time and volunteering and giving so that we can have our young people grow into future leaders. So again, thank you to the residents of Freedom Village, and again, thank you for all of you for being here today and the great jobs that you all do. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brian. All right. The mission of the Manatee School District is to educate and develop all students today for their success tomorrow. That's pretty profound. It's simple and yet profound. The development of partnerships is an integral strategy of this mission, and it's through the Business and Education Partnership Program that this goal is being accomplished. To provide more insight from the school's perspective about the importance and impact of business partnerships, Dr. Diana Green could not be with us this morning, but we did get a video. So please enjoy this video from Dr. Green, the superintendent of Manatee County School District.
Good morning. I am sorry that I am not able to personally join you this morning for what is traditionally one of the highlights of the school year, the annual Business and Education Partnership Awards. I am sure you are all having a wonderful time celebrating the outstanding relationships that have been built mutually between our schools and local businesses, churches, civic organizations, and other service groups. The reason I could not be with you is because I have been asked by Florida Education Commissioner Pam Stewart to serve on a statewide panel that convenes today in Orlando. You may have heard about the five C's I've mentioned wherever I speak to our school district employees about this school year. Those five C's are calmness, consistency, civility, confidence, and community. I talk about calmness, consistency, and civility because I want our students, teachers, school staffs, and administrators to fully focus on what is most important: making sure our students are getting a first-class education in our schools every single day. It can be easy to get distracted when the winds of change are swirling around you and there is an air of uncertainty about state accountability testing, district leadership, or other outside issues that impact our students and schools. Regardless of what is happening outside of our classrooms, the 6,000 plus employees of the school district must be devoted to our stated mission of educating and developing all of our students today for their success tomorrow. I speak of the fourth C, confidence, because I firmly believe in the people we have in place and their ability to get the job done. The final C I talk about is community, and that is where all of you come in. We simply cannot be successful without your support, your involvement, your assistance, and your inspiration. Every time you reach out to help one of our students, our schools, you are teaching a valuable lesson to all of those you touch. You are teaching the lesson that pitching in and working together helps us all accomplish more and advance faster than if we are left to our own devices. You are demonstrating that education is important in Manatee County and that our community cares about the future of all of our children. Again, I am sorry I could not be with you. I want to personally thank the Manatee Chamber of Commerce, Bright House, Freedom Village, and all of the sponsors that made this 25th anniversary awards event possible. Have a great morning, and again, thank you for supporting our students and schools.
Thank you, Dr. Green. She was so excited, hardly got her name out before she was up. As a side note, I'm on the board of the South Florida Museum, and I have a video on my phone of Dr. Green getting a kiss from Snooty. So if you'd like to see Green turn red, just come up and I'll show you that. Anyway, As we've learned, when businesses take part in the education of young people, they are helping to develop our future leaders and workforce. This business-based dedication is at the heart of the awards we are presenting today. Before we begin the most important part of this morning's activity, I'd like to take a moment to recognize the selection committee members of the 2015 Partnership Awards. It's a tough job. And we know this was a tough process, and we appreciate your time and interest. Please stand as I call your name, and audience, hold your applause until the end. These folks did work hard. They had to read through all of the applications that came in and come to the agonizing decisions of the winners and who didn't win. But first, Bob Goss, chair of the Manatee County School Board. Trudy Moon, Air and Energy. If you'll stand as I call your name. Jennifer Seavey, Air Products. Stand. Jennifer Seavey, Air Products and Chemicals. Michael Barber, School District of Manatee County. And Lynn Lineman with C1 Bank. All right, this is your selection committee. Let's give them a hand. All right. We are proud to recognize all of those nominated for this year's Business and Education Partnership Awards with a certificate of appreciation. Nominees, if you did not receive your certificate when you checked in, please stop by the registration table at the end of the event. They'll have that for you. Each of the nominees will be listed on the screen behind me and in your program. And our winners will receive this beautiful award. Thanks to our award sponsor, Trophy Case, my buddy Don Ide, which will be presented by our sponsors and members of our Education and Workforce Partnership Committee. We also have some great students to help present the awards today. And they are, from Bayshore High School, Sebastian Zacharias, Ariel Diaz, Sophia Gallegos, and Estefanie Oliveira. I didn't practice that one enough. Estefanie Oliveira. Let's give them a hand. They're behind this screen, but they'll be out here shortly. And some of our newest presenters, and absolutely the cutest, I apologize to the high schoolers, but are Micah and Lucy Kennedy. And they'll be helping us out. You'll see what I'm talking about. All right, will the winner in each category or a representative please come forward to receive the award when your name is called? We also invite you to say a few words about your partnership experience. And at the end of the program, we're going to ask all the winners to meet backstage for a group photo. Now, our first category, we're into it, finally. Our first category award winner will be presented by Jennifer Seavey of Air Products and Chemicals. Jennifer, come on down.
Ooh, I like that music. Good morning. The Rookie of the Year, this award is given to a partner with less than 1 year of participation. As a new partner with the school district, this partner worked closely with school staff to ensure community events were successful and school district personnel were well cared for. When a new superintendent arrived in 2013, the school district knew the importance of garnering community involvement and support. To accomplish this, several informational lunches were scheduled at a local restaurant. Thanks to the support of this business partner, there was minimal cost to hold these community forums called Soup with Soup. In addition to this leadership level support, this partner also sponsored several catered meals to local schools during Teacher Appreciation Week and provided lunches for over 50 people during a district job fair. Although new as a partner with the schools, this business has earned an A+ for their commitment to our school district. Please join me in congratulating the winner of the 2015 Rookie of the Year Award, The Ranch Grill. Oh, how cute.
Well, it's an honor, obviously, to be nominated and then to win. The Ranch Grill has been proud to be a partner in education We are a true believer of education, and that is today's future. So again, we're very proud to be the winner. Thank you.
I told you they were cute. All right. Good job, Ranch Grill. I never worked in a grill. I worked in a deli once, but I couldn't slice it. Sorry. John Horn saying, cut the restaurant jokes, Lee. I can't cut the mustard. I'm sorry. All right. Our next award will be presented by Angie Grossberger, president of the National Career Academy Coalition, longtime member of the Manatee County School District. And Angie, come on up.
Partner of the Year. With this award, we recognize a civic, church, or nonprofit organization that shows the highest level of participation. This organization has made a tremendous impact on their partner school and the surrounding community. On a daily basis, this partner has provided services to students and staff that have helped their school accomplish academic and support service projects that normally would have been difficult to attain. During school breaks, this business partner sent over 20 missionary students and adults to help beautify the campus and assist the custodial staff in grounds maintenance. During recognition weeks and holidays, this partner provided delicious lunches for every staff member and routinely donated gift cards to recognize the efforts of the staff. The generosity of this partner didn't stop with the staff. They routinely assisted students and families in need, prayed for students and staff members, and visited sick or disabled staff during difficult times. On top of all this, a special group of volunteers from this organization worked with fifth graders every Tuesday, providing proctors for FSA testing and musical equipment for various events. In the words of the school's business coordinator, this partner spirit invades our school, and we all appreciate their presence and support. Congratulations to Good Life Church, the 2015 Civic Partner of the Year.
Well, thank you so much for this award. I just want to tell you that I received this for all the members of Good Life Church and all the people in our community that want to make a difference at Terra Elementary School. I read a book in 2012 that really impacted the way I saw ministry. And in the book, a guy named Reggie McNeil says in Missional Renaissance, he makes a statement. He said, most churches in the United States, if they were to close their doors, the only people that would notice it would be the people that attend the church. And I remember sitting in a cubicle as I prepared to plant the church here in Bradenton that I didn't want to be a church like that. I wanted to be a church that actually made a difference in the community. The mission of our church is to love people enough to share the good news of Jesus in our lives as well. And our partnership with Terra Elementary School is a partnership in which if anybody in this community feels the love of God and feels what it's like to have somebody walk alongside of them in life, it's going to be Terra. If we fail at Terra, we fail everywhere. And so really my heart is to continue to invest in leaders to plant other churches that can partner with other schools in the area to make a difference in our community. And so if that's something that you're interested in getting behind, I'd love to talk to you afterward. And if you're representative of a school who's open to having a church meet in your school or partner with your school, I'd love to share that as well. I'd love to see that happen. Thank you again. And I want to make a special recognition. Jared, if you could stand up real quick. This is Jared Clark. Jared is our family and children's pastor. He really, in this year, has been the one who has taken the bull by the horns and done everything that's needed to be done on campus, and as well as all the people from Good Life that are back there that invest their time. So thank you so much for the award, and we appreciate it.
All right. Thank you, Jason. Well stated. Our next presenter is Kristen Pepper. Kristen, come on down. Let's hear the music.
Yeah. Good morning. Good things come in small packages. This award is targeted towards small businesses, 20 or fewer employees, that have demonstrated a high level of participation. As usual, this category was very competitive, but this organization rose to the top and exemplified how a small business can make a big impact. When this business partner's owner became the PTO president at the school described her influence as a refreshing, refreshing wave of positivity that reached the entire school community. Because of the owner's commitment to the school, a new mascot emerged and became a role model for the students. Master Jack was a major personality at many events and could be seen on campus throughout the year, not only entertaining the students, but modeling appropriate behavior and self-discipline. In addition, this business provided class discounts for students, no student training days at their facility for teachers, and even financial contributions to cover the costs for students to participate on field trips. This partner was so giving of their resources that when the school realized that they were short staffed for state required testing, the business jumped in and provided large group activities and lessons that freed up the staff to focus on administering the tests. This school's business partnership coordinator describes their partner as a positive leader, but states their most valuable contribution has been a change agent to the culture of the entire school. Please join me in recognizing Bostock's Martial Arts and Fitness as the 2015 Good Things Come in Small Packages Award winner.
Didn't know we were going to win, so I don't have anything prepared. We love children, and we believe that if you educate children in the proper way to eat, diabetes is the rising illness in children. That is scary. Drowning in Florida, where we have pools and water, and kids don't know how to swim. Education is more than 2 and 2 is 4. It's learning how to eat healthy, how to have a healthy lifestyle, how to be safe, how to learn to defend yourself, how to stand up for yourself, how to have confidence. So our staff, we don't have a staff. We're family owned. It's me and my son and my daughter and my son-in-law and my nephews, and those are the people who run our business. And we've been doing this for 20 years here in Bradenton, and we just believe in our children. And I look out and I see a lot of our parents who are out there that have supported us for a long time. So I want to thank you guys, because you make the difference. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And Kristen, I owe you an apology. I forgot to share that Kristen is the service center manager of Suncoast Credit Union, a fellow finance person. So thank you, Kristen, appreciate it. All right. Now, the next presenter is a longtime committee member and a good friend, Dave Potter. Come on down, Dave Potter. Dave used to run family partnerships here in Bradenton. And anybody that knows Dave knows he can talk very fast. He can talk very fast. So I've asked Dave to take his foot off the gas. Thank you, sir.
Like I said last year, Jana threatens us to stay on script. So you're lucky. Good things come in big packages, too. This award is targeted toward businesses with over 20 employees that have demonstrated a high level of participation. Although I'm not a new partner with Bayshore High School, this organization's involvement has provided life-changing opportunities for the students at this school. For many years, this partner volunteered to interview students as they prepared for an off-campus leadership seminar. Students who participated in the seminar, called the Seminar for Tomorrow's Leaders, often reported the experience was life-changing. This past year, the partnership between Bayshore and this organization expanded to include a new program that enhanced the current emphasis on youth leadership development. Thanks to the generosity of this business partner, many students gained valuable experiences that will impact their future successes in life. Congratulations to the Rotary Club of West Bradenton on their award.
You can mail that. Oh, okay. Thank you. Okay. Well, we are honored, and I wanted to tell you that since 1981, the Rotary Club of West Bradenton, through our youth services programs, has provided quite an impact to our young student leaders. And we appreciate this award. And on behalf of our club, thank you very much.
All righty. Thank you, Tom. Thank you, David. And congratulations to the Rotary Club of West Bradenton. All right. Our next presenter is the principal of Horizons Academy and Central High School. Some people call him Tiny, but I call him Friend. Omar Edwards. Let's give Omar a hand.
Should have been Monday Night Football. Monday Night Football.
It's a two-way street. This award is presented to a school and their partner for giving back to each other through publicity, recognition, and support of the partnerships. This year's winner was able to partner and have realized the value of benefiting from these relationships, knowing what they do together to win for the students. In order to ensure the students comply with the requirements of having lanyards on their campus, 1,200 lanyards needed to be purchased. This sponsoring of business partner, the lanyards was provided free to the entire student body, staff and students. As part of the sponsorship, the business was able to advertise on the back of their badges. Not only did the business gain exposure to all student, staffs and families, the advertising opportunities extended to the community whenever the students and staff had provided identification, such as movie theaters for traveling purposes. In addition to the sponsorships, the business partner participated in the school's Banner Buddy program and purchased advertising in the school program. In all this, the partner truly treated business partnerships as a win-win relationship, giving back to each other for the resources graciously offered. Congratulations to Nolan Middle School and its business partner, Baker Orthodontics, winner of the 2015 It's a Two-Way Street Award.
Good morning. Thank you for this. Is this mic on? Good morning. There we go. Thank you for this award and the recognition. As an orthodontist, I work mainly with children, so being a part of their education is an important thing for me and my staff, and we thank you all for the award. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, congratulations to Baker Orthodontics and Nolan Middle School. I told the representatives from Baker Orthodontics earlier, brace yourself. I'm sorry. It's a volunteer gig. All right, moving right along. Our next presenter is Roy Nellis, Adult Career and Technical Education, School District of Manatee County. Come on up, Roy.
Hi, good morning. This next award is Partners Together. This award is given to two or more partners collaborating together on one project. The two partners selected for this category are not new to giving back to the schools and to the community. Because of their partnership, these organizations have helped impact two distinct but complementary programs at Bayshore High School. Since the mid-1930s, these two groups founding organizations have offered a program for both high school boys and girls that teach students how their state and local government works while developing leadership skills and an appreciation for their rights as citizens. The financial support of these organizations allows student delegates to attend Florida State University each summer to gain valuable civic experiences. Many of these students would not get the opportunity to learn responsible citizenship without the support of these business partners. Congratulations to the 2015 Partners Together Award winners, American Legion Auxiliary Post 24 and Post 317.
I just want to say thank you. It's an honor to accept this award. My name is Barbara Field. I'm the president of the Auxiliary Unit 24, and we do Girl State every year, and it's just a pleasure to see these young ladies go to Tallahassee and learn about our government and come back being so inspired. Thank you.
On behalf of Post 317, we have been supporting the Boys State well long before I even took over. I've been with them for at least the last 7 years, and it's been a pleasure to see these young men go to Tallahassee and come back and have won my past year. This past year's was presenting one of the awards, so it's good to have both of our Boys Staters at the award ceremony.
All right, congratulations, American Legion Auxiliary Post 24 and 317. Isn't it amazing what our local businesses are doing in our schools? There are so many ways businesses can be involved. It really is. Now, We had a cancellation. One of the members from our committee could not make it this morning. So I would like to ask Lynn Lineman with C1 Bank to come and present the next award. This is a special one-time project. This award is given to a partner that gives a one-time, focused effort that displays creativity, teamwork, and resource utilization. Investing in the local community is one mission of this business partner. Making a big impact on a small school is the result of the local investment of this partner. From donating lunches to the staff to providing achievement awards and recognitions to students, this business goes above and beyond for Myakka Elementary School. However, it was one project last year that helped boost technology experiences for both students and teachers at Myakka Elementary. Thanks to this company's $60,000, that's a six with four zeros after it, grant laptops were purchased for students and Mimeo boards were installed in all the classrooms at this small rural school. With a student population of less than 300, funds for supplemental supplies and equipment are often lacking. Because of the tremendous support of this business partner, the students and staff at Myakka Elementary have received incredibly valuable tools to ensure successful future for those children. Please join me in congratulating the winner of the 2015 Special One-Time Project Award, the Mosaic Company, the lovely Jackie Barron. Come on down.
Well, it's both an honor and a privilege to partner with Myakka City. The grant was a thrill to be able to make that happen for them, but we're just as excited when we can send their top achieving students on a limo ride in the spring. You know, I would never have been in that limo as a student myself, but I'm glad that we're able to make that possible for those students who work so hard all year long. And for the men and women who work at the neighboring Wingate Mine, helping with Myakka City Elementary, I mean, they really enjoy it. This past July, we had a fish fry to raise funds for teacher supplies at our Welcome Back Luncheon. And in partnering with the Lakewood Ranch Kiwanis Club, we raised a record $1,400 to help those teachers start the school year off right. So under the leadership of Kathy Price and her team, to Mosaic, when it comes to Myakka City Elementary, it's really more like family. And of course, that's its own reward. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you, Jackie, and congratulations to Mosaic. Okay. Our next presenter is Francine Deemer. Francine is Development Director with the Boys and Girls Clubs of Manatee County. Francine, come on down.
I didn't know my family was here today. They usually sleep in late. Good morning, everyone. The District-Wide Partner Award is given to the business that supports multiple schools throughout the district. It's difficult to describe this business without giving them away. I will let you know this business partner opened its, has been involved with many local schools since it opened its doors in 2001. This business prides itself on having a positive influence on all who come in contact with them. They care greatly about the community in which they operate and have chosen first and foremost to support kids and youth through their school programs. From hosting school spirit night dinners and donating profits to providing gift certificates for free products, and not to mention their traveling dancing cow. This business loves their schools and contributes greatly to each school's success. Congratulations to the 2015 winner of the District-Wide Partner Award. Can you guess? Chick-fil-A Creekwood.
Thank you.
on behalf of Chick-fil-A, no Cal tonight, he's at the barn getting ready for a game tonight at Lakewood Ranch. On behalf of Chick-fil-A, it is an honor to give back to our students and our school staff, and it's certainly our pleasure. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you, Francine, and thank you and congratulations, Chick-fil-A. As you've seen, there are so many ways your business can be involved. If you would like information about the Electronic Partners in Education program, please visit the Chamber of the School District's website or speak to any of our award presenters today after the program. Now, to present our next award, please welcome Bob Goss with Allison Goss Engineering, one of our supporting sponsors. Come on down, Bob.
Hey there. I get to wear a lot of hats in the community, occasionally a little bit of Kevlar. The School Coordinator of the Year. This award recognizes the school representative who provides leadership, dedication, and communication affecting the overall involvement of business partners. Engaging businesses and building strong relationships with these businesses is the key to garnering long-term support for our students. In fact, my colleagues who are here today my other colleague all talked about this on Tuesday about how important we at the board level feel that encouraging the business partner program is to the district and to the schools that the partners serve. This mission is at the heart of the Business and Education Partnership Program, and the success of this mission lies in the hands of the school coordinator. Today we are recognizing an individual who has served the education community for over 16 years, but he only arrived in Manatee County a few short years ago. In 2012, this dedicated individual established himself as a leader, mentor, and advocate for students through his commitment to developing a strong business partnership program at his school. This school coordinator realizes the importance of business involvement in the schools and also understands this relationship should benefit both the school and the business. So it is my pleasure to present the 2015 School Coordinator of the Year to Mario Mendoza, principal at Wakeland Elementary School of International Studies. Mario, come on up.
Here's Haas now.
Well, I was really unprepared for this. I did not know that I was even up for the award. And to be quite honest, I almost feel undeserving because I know we have a lot of great business partners at many of our schools. And quite frankly, we have a lot of great business partners at my school. And we always talk about trying to make a win-win, create win-win scenarios where really one is not making out or really winning a lot over the other. But our business partners step up all the time. And as much as I want to thank and show appreciation, they continue to step up and go above and beyond. We had the Bostocks here tonight. The Pirates are one of the others, the Pirates and Marauders, with the smallest, simplest things. I'll give you an example with the Marauders. They do host, right across the street from us, an awards assembly monthly for Student of the Month. They bring over a Pirates player to speak to the kids. They look forward to this all the time. They'll sign autograph the balls, give posters away, all kinds of things, provide lunch. Parents are invited to come, and they do this monthly. What do the Pirates get out of this? Well, if you ask them, you talk to Trevor, I'm not even sure if he's here today right now, but he'll say, well, it gives our players an opportunity to speak publicly, and that's the win for them. I think our school is making out on that one, okay? So, So those are the kinds of things that all of our business partners continue to step up with. And so to win this award for having such amazing business partners, I don't feel like I was the one that did the work. So I want to thank all of our business partners. Really, this goes out for all of Wakeland, the support of the school district, and again, all of our business partners. So thank you.
Thank you, Mario. And congratulations. Humble guy. Stay humble and be proud of it. Anyway. All right. And now we have Bob Herman of Labinal Power Systems to present the next award. Robert, come on down. Robert is a plant manager.
Won't even ask. Morning. This next award is for Business Coordinator of the Year. This award recognizes the business representative who provides leadership, dedication, and communication affecting the overall involvement of the business partners. Having been a business partner for several years, the owner of this business knows the importance of being involved in our local schools. This business owner would often reach out to the schools before being asked. This past year, this business partner coordinator sought out opportunities to serve the schools throughout the county by offering free meals for special celebrations for staff and students. When resources were tight, this partner stepped in to make sure students, staff, and volunteers received the recognition for their hard work by donating delicious meals. By providing leadership and dedication, this business partner has exemplified the goals of the Business Partnership Program. Congratulations to Joe Martin of Mexicali Border Cafe, the 2015 Business Coordinator of the Year. Mr. Martin is unable to be here this morning, but we have Crystal Gonzalez and Shannon Goweski to receive on his behalf.
Good morning, and thank you for this award. Joe couldn't be here this morning. He's actually out of town. I know he appreciates everything and appreciates the opportunity to be an active member in the community. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Bob, and congratulations to Mexicali Border Cafe. And I apologize. They were sitting here earlier, and I walked up and said, are you students here? Complimentary, they're so young. All right. Our next award, named after the late Barry Jones, Tampa Bay Rays community representative, pictured on the screen, will be presented to a business partner that empowers others to make a difference for our schools, teachers, and our students. Here to help present the Barry Jones Business Partner Empowerment Award are Deborah Gambino, Community Engagement Specialist for the School District of Manatee County. And it's fun to hear her speak. Linda Tompkins Jones, widow of Barry Jones, will follow and say some brief words about Barry. Come on down, guys.
Good morning. Thank you. It is during the first years of a child's life that their future educational success is determined. Providing support and high-quality school readiness for all children and their families has been a priority for this local organization for many years. In 2014, the School District of Manatee County partnered with this nominee to provide valuable educational content to their newly created publication that has become a valuable family education and resource guide to more than 25,000 elementary students and families. Through this publication, the current and next generation of parents receive informative and enriching articles related to education, healthcare, and community programs, all packaged in a beautifully produced magazine. In addition to providing written resources, this nonprofit agency continues to enhance their programs to provide quality care and educational programs to as many children as possible in Manatee County. We are proud to present today the 2015 Barry Jones Empowerment Award to the Early Learning Coalition of Manatee County.
Thank you. Deb's the only person in here who understands me. Paul, my CEO, said, you have to go up. We have to prove we have staff from Arcadia. So first of all, both of us were kind of lost for words, which is one of the first times for Paul. It's an amazing honor for us to get this award. So many people in this room have helped over the last year with the magazine. We couldn't have done it without the support of those people, and our partnership with the school district has been phenomenal. The magazine just won an award itself in Orlando as best new magazine in the whole state, which I think was just fantastic for us. The whole concept was to provide Manatee County with something it could be proud of. The magazine goes in the backpacks of every elementary student. We've increased the distribution now to 35,000. We're discussing going into the middle schools. So it's really exciting for the whole coalition. And I think, you know, the most important thing is that everything that gets generated from the magazine gets reinvested in the ELC. Every dollar that we get from NextGen goes back to our programs. So everyone in here, thank you so much. I know there's a lot of you who are involved in NextGen as we go through the year, and I'd just like to say a huge thank you to everyone. And hopefully we've done what we said we would do with the magazine. Thank you.
And Linda Tompkins-Jones would like to say a few words about the Barry Jones Award.
Thank you. Barry was passionate about personal empowerment, excellence, and community. So I just want to say I'm truly grateful that every year he's remembered with this wonderful award. Thank you so much.
All right. Actually, Deborah Gambino has a deep Southern accent, but working with Dara all that time kind of rubbed off on her. So. Anyway, all right. Now here to present the final award. We're in pretty good. To present the final award is Dennis Schaefer again from Bright House Networks Business Solution, our presenting sponsor, and Jonathan Fleece, our chair of the Manatee Chamber. Jonathan, Dennis, come on down.
So I came in here this morning, it's my first trip in here and first big event here at Manatee, and I saw Jonathan and I hadn't met Lynn, and I saw you beautiful women out there and good looking men, and I said, what does Lynn look like? He said, Lynn's sort of tall, maybe a little bit overweight, gray hair and balding. I thought, I can find this woman easily.
Partner in excellence.
This award is really the pinnacle of today's event. This honor is bestowed upon the partner that has typified the mission of the Manatee Partnership Program through active and exemplary accomplishments of the various levels of participation. The recipient of this award was chosen by the selection committee from every single one of the nominations that have been submitted this year.
Not enough room for us, is there? I gotta cheat. The winner this year is truly a partner in educational excellence because they are so ingrained in our community. I'm going to try my best to describe their contributions without giving them away too quickly. For over 13 years, this business has worked hard to help both students and staff achieve success on so many levels.
With several locations throughout Manatee County, this partner has the capacity to connect with many schools and has done so for many, many years. Each year, this business partner has donated over $5,000 towards scholarships through the Manatee Education Foundation. These scholarships impact many students in so many ways, from support for post-secondary education to funds for classrooms to help enhance educational opportunities. In addition to these scholarships, this business donates countless gift cards that are used as rewards and fundraising items throughout our school district.
This business's support doesn't end with just the students. Each year, this partner hosts a holiday dinner for several schools, inviting the entire school staff to the special event. During these dinners, this partner provides a delicious holiday meal, prizes, and raffle items. These holiday dinners help boost staff morale and provide a rewarding evening for all who attend.
Although this business provides a tremendous amount of support to the schools, they always want to do more. And frankly, we have barely touched the surface of the countless ways that this business and the two owners behind it contribute to our community. These two individuals are quiet giants with hearts bigger than sunshine. Please help us in congratulating our 2015 Partner in Excellence, John and Amanda Horn, Anna Maria Oysterbar.
I was expecting Margaritaville to be playing. Have you got the 7-second delay going? All right. You'll need it. This is truly an honor. It's just awesome. I was fortunate enough to be the MC a few years ago with Ellen Aquavelva, as I call her. And it's just wonderful what the chamber's doing to say thanks to the businesses. There's so many businesses that get so involved and so behind schools. It's awesome. And to receive this after all the years is awesome as well. So thank you for everybody that helps the schools. And thanks for the acknowledgement. We're proud to do what we do. We've done teacher dinners, which has been fun. We close a restaurant for our staff party every year at Christmas time. So we've picked 30 different schools and hosted all the staff, the custodians, to the principal, and we have a great time. This year we're gonna do something different. And it came from when I was on the superintendent search committee because I met so many different people. But we're gonna do the school bus drivers this year. And so we're gonna do it. We've been working with Bruce and a couple of different ones. I think we're going to do it at the school board property on 63rd. They're going to get a tent and everything, because we can't get 300 people in one of our restaurants. So, but we're excited to be able to say thanks to the school bus drivers this year. Don't tell anybody because they don't know yet. And I'm also very fortunate. I don't have a problem with a guy named Lynn. I have three of them in my family. My father is Lynn Horn, spelled L-Y-N-N, just like Lynn Lyman. He's a overweight, graying, balding fella too.
Don't tell him.
My brother is Lynn Horn Jr. He's been bald for years, so we don't know if he's gray or not. We won't get into overweight. His son, my nephew, Lynn Horn III, Trey, is receding quickly. Trey is interning with us this year. I think he started 5 years ago on his intern program. So we're not real bright in the Horn family, but we get to the end at some point. The most important person in the Horn family is my wife. I would say that this would never have happened with my ex-wife, but she was sitting right behind me tonight, so. Beth, I love you still. My ex-wife is my favorite ex-wife. And she's part of the Manatee School District. So thanks so much. Thank y'all.
I'll tell you that there are no two people that do any more for this community than those two right there. I'm just so happy to see them get this award. Quite often people walk up and say, oh, do you have children? John and Amanda can say, we've got them all over Manatee County. They really do. All right. Thank you to all of our award presenters. A special thank you to the Sarah Bay Dance Club. That was fantastic. Truly a talented group of kids. I'd like now to take the opportunity to thank and recognize all the businesses, organizations, and individuals that have helped our students through business and education partnerships. It's through your dedication, encouragement, and continued support that we're all reminded of the difference we can make. Thank you also to those businesses and organizations that have created a legacy of giving to our schools. If your business has partnered with a school for more than 5 years, could you stand? Just more than 5 years, anytime. Thank you. Let's give them a hand. Thank you so much. We won't do the 10, 15, 20. If you're not sure how you can be involved as a business partner, ask one of these that are standing or just stood. I'm sure they'll inspire you, as many have this morning. By the way, no one knew that they were winning this award, so these little talks were off the cuff, and John, he can talk off the cuff anywhere, anytime, but that was just great. They'll inspire you. Please give all these businesses and organizations your full support and do business with them. Again, we thank you to our presenting sponsor, Bright House Networks Business Solutions, also to Freedom Village, Labanel Power Systems, Allison Gauze Engineering, Paul Mprinty, The Trophin Case, Tropicana, and MET, Manatee Educational Television, for their continued support. I congratulate all of our partners for the extraordinary work highlighted this morning and encourage you to find new ways to become involved. I also encourage you to reach out to other businesses and organizations that you work with and tell them about your partnership experience. Think of what we have accomplished together and imagine what we can do with additional partners. The Manatee Chamber Workforce and Education Partnership Committee welcomes anyone interested to make an impact on the future of our workforce. So please contact the Chamber to see how you can get involved. Finally, I would like to remind all of today's award winners to come to the stage at the end of the event for some photographs. That's it. I leave you with one thought. Everything that we do, everything that we talked about this morning, in some way, shape, or form, touched a life out there. And we have no idea where that life will go or what great things will be done, but just know that you were part of it. Thank you very much. Class is dismissed.
Thank you.